Hi, Spencer. Dorothy Gentry, iMessenger Media. Welcome.
How are you doing? Oh, sorry.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Talk about the road back to the Mavericks.
I mean, obviously, you know, y'all traded me, so you feel me? Back to a team that I was on previously. Yeah, and then, you know, I was there, we went to the playoffs, had a little bit of success to end that season, which was, you know, fun. You know, we were gonna start a new season and had a lot of optimism. You know, got some friends over there. Nick Claxton was my rookie. You know, Doe, obviously, we had formed a pretty big bond. Dennis Smith Jr., amongst others, just kind of, you know, people you guys are familiar with. The season didn't go the way we kind of wanted it to go. We weren't, you know, having much success in terms of wins and losses. You know, they decided to make a certain move, and, you know, I kind of had a choice between kind of like sitting with the Raptors for the rest of the year or trying to join a contender, understanding even though that would burn up my bird rights and make free agency harder. But, you know, when you're in the position or, you know, you've been in the league that long, you kind of, you want to play meaningful basketball. So shout out to the Raptors for being, you know, first class and whatnot. Yeah, and then I had a decision between the Lakers and the Mavs. I mean, a couple others, but mainly those two. And anytime, you know, I've kind of been knocked down, I try to take, you know, the harder path and not necessarily make it harder on myself, but just in terms of like that growth, right? And you know, so when I made, obviously, which everybody's gonna ask about the comments, it was all about comfort zones. It was funny because both LA and Dallas fan bases kind of thought it was like about them, but it really wasn't. It was like man versus bully, you know what I'm saying? So given what happened with Brooklyn and being top five in multiple categories, you know, points and threes and assists, and to kind of have that exit play out like that, obviously, you know, sucked, hurt, you know, all those other things. So I was, the perspective was man versus bully. It really had nothing to do with either fan base, to be honest. And yeah, so that was it. I was facing some adversity and tried to take a harder path and in terms of just growth. And so far in my life, that's pretty much served me well. It's how I got to the NBA. It's how I rehabbed an ACL in 5 months. You know, fastest in basketball history, at least. I think there was a soccer player that beat me. Did in like 3.5 or something, but that's a whole other thing. That's really all it comes down to. Oh, amazing. I mean, you know, I've probably the most consistent basketball that I've played has been in a Mavs jersey. The farthest I've gone in the playoffs, Western Conference Finals, was in a Mavs jersey. And ironically, 6 months ago, I bought my family home in Dallas. So, you know, it's, and I get to now live in it. So, you know, it's fun and it's great to be back. And obviously these guys are my friends. I'm still familiar with over half the team. I mean, Maxey, Dwight Powell, like just all the cornerstones of the Mavs franchise that are all still here. And, you know, as much as he won't admit this, Sweeney loves me. I don't know if y'all know Sweeney, but Sweeney loves me. That's my dog. So, you know, he's happy I'm back.
Dwayne Price, Mavs.com. Spencer, what was that like for you being away from the team the last 2 years? And much has changed in the backcourt. Kyrie is here, and now Clay is here. So how do you fit in?
Yeah, so, you know, I played with Kyrie in Brooklyn, familiar with him, obviously familiar with Luka for a couple years. Clay I've never played with, but, you know, early on, obviously, in practices, runs, whatever, like, you can see how seamless of a fit Clay's going to be. Like, he's a top, what, 2-3 shooter of all time, which is, I mean, sensational, right? Like, anytime you're top 2 or 3 at anything in the world, like, you're amazing. But, yeah, I mean, on the better teams I've been on, you know, it's all about just kind of plugging in the gaps. You know, if it needs to be a little bit of pace, if, you know, Luka's tired or something, maybe I do that. If it needs to be spot-up shooting because Kyrie's cooking, and I do that. If Clay's cooking, I need to be passing him the ball, and you do that. And, you know, if all three are rolling and you got to play defense, I mean, we even saw that with the Lakers. Like, you know, in the last, you know, 15, 20 games of the season, they relied on me as, like, the end-of-game stopper, you know. And so just doing whatever it takes to win.
Hey Spencer. Landon Thomas, Mavs Fans for Life. First of all, welcome back.
Thank you.
You know, just going off of your response, you know, that's one of the biggest things about your game is the adaptability and the versatility as well, being able to play a role on which team, you know, wants from you.
Yeah.
Where does that come from? Where a lot of players just have roles, but you can
fluidity. I mean, probably the fact that one, like, I'm always trying to win the game. So every decision I'm making is with that in mind. Like, I'm not coming in with preconceived notions or anything like that. But then two, probably because my basketball road has been very up and down. Like, I wasn't the number one recruit in high school, you know, and so every point in time, like, you kind of have to figure out how to play with a different team, a different big-time player. It could be that the big man is the big-time guy, so now you're feeding him. It could be that there's another guard you're playing off of. And then sometimes you are the guy, too. So, like, I've literally in the NBA been 15th on the bench, like, knew I wasn't playing. Like, I might as well have just worn street clothes, even though I had a jersey on, all the way up to really probably about, like, second. You know what I'm saying? And then even moonlighted as a one when, like, the top guy would be hurt or something like that, you know, and average 20, 30, game winners, this, that, and the third, done all of it. You know what I mean? So it's just figuring out where you fit, how you help the specific team you're on, and going from there.
Looking in, you know, when you see this team in the finals, what was your assessment of the team and now that you're coming into a new season?
Well, obviously this team is different, especially adding Clay. And losing D. Jones, who I think, you know, brought a ton of athleticism and defense, obviously, to the team. But overall, I mean, I in the finals, like I kind of said, the Celtics, they were able to put five guys out there that could all kind of shoot. And it kind of bent the defense a little bit, and they knocked down shots, and they were, you know, able to win a championship. So hats off to them. Obviously, you know, the ball club that's, you know, in this room all wants to win. Understands where they fell short last year. We're all bought into that idea of doing it. We understand we need health, good fortune, you know, all that other stuff to go our way, but that's the North Star and that's the goal.
Right here in the front, Valencia King. Come on. Do we want to air guitar battle? Because I will win.
No, I don't want that.
Okay, I can do it.
They make theirs and whatnot, and, you know, I'm never going to shy away from that, so. There we go.
Very glad to have you back. Welcome back. Serious question, real serious.
Yeah.
You put a poll on your Instagram, if memory serves me correct, about hair, no hair.
Yeah.
What was the deciding factor for the decision?
Oh, my mom. Mm.
Yeah. What'd she say?
She just liked it when I cut my hair. She thinks I look like cleaner and younger and all that. And I'm not homeless, so I was like, all right.
Basically. Shout out to moms for keeping it real.
Yeah.
Shout out to mine. Okay.
There you go.
And outside of that, for your off season, obviously you're not new to having a good off season. Mm-hmm. But what was the most enjoyable part for you outside of basketball? I know you said you got the family home here in Dallas, so.
I mean, this didn't happen in the off season, but it happened leading up to my off season. My second son was born, so that was cool. So now I got like a little fat version of my dad, like. Crying in the house. No, I'm serious. He looked like he looks like he's 65, but he's 6 months. I promise you. Y'all laughing. I'm being serious. Yeah.
Has it been being a dad or two? Is that an adjustment for you?
I'm not even going to sit here and lie to y'all. I have a nanny. So, like, there's help. But I love being a dad. I don't like diapers, but all the fun stuff, like, it's great. Like, when they smile, like, there's nothing that matches that. There's no, you know, high or warmth or anything. It just changes your day. So, you know, I love that for sure.
Listen, my show is Real Talk Sports, so we definitely appreciate the real talk.
The real talk. Okay. There it is.
All right, last one for Spence.
And this is a two-part question, Spence.
What's up?
Chris with CNO.com. Yeah. When you got the news before you made, obviously, your decision, Klay Thompson was coming to the Mavericks.
Yeah.
What was your thoughts about that? Did that help make your decision to come back?
I mean, yeah, like I said, you want to play meaningful basketball. I think, you know, primarily again, like, you know, you have some other options, but primarily again, it was like Lakers, Mavs, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I made a different decision this time. I mean, you know.
And, last question. So this is a unique situation. I've asked the two other guys that have signature shoes. There's four guys on this team.
I know.
How is that? Because you got Luka, Jordan Brand, the two Atlanta guys, and you got 361. I want you to talk about that because it's Aaron Gordon, yourself, and Jokic, right?
Yeah.
Can you talk about that brand and just how is it to have four guys on the team with signature shoes?
I mean, it seems kind of unprecedented, to be honest. I don't know of another time that that happened. You want me to talk about 361 or just like, oh, yeah, nah. I mean, they're a Chinese brand. They're really big in China. You know, one thing that I've noticed is that they gravitate towards stories of hard work and perseverance. And I think, you know, that's one of the reasons why we align so well. Obviously, coming off ACL and, like I kind of mentioned, the recovery and all that stuff. And, you know, just, hooping. I mean, shit, I was averaging like 21 at the time. So, you know, and then it was a good marriage. I had my own shoe prior to that. And then we kind of collaborated. Now they do all the stuff. And they've been a dream partner to work with. I love my signature shoe. You know, the third one's coming out this year with 361. I'm actually wearing Elijah's colorway. It's always like a green one, which y'all have seen before, obviously, on the Mavs court. So, yeah, we got like, you know, another like 10, 12 colorways coming in. Yeah, it's fun. It's fun. Thank you,
Spence,
boss.
Appreciate it.